You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of Chronicle of a Death Foretold, a famous work by Gabriel García Márquez. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Gabriel García Márquez was born in 1927 in the remote, impoverished town of Aracataca in northern Colombia. His main literary influences were the American writer William Faulkner, 1897-1962, and his maternal grandparents and aunts, with whom he grew up. His grandfather, who had fought in the Thousand Days War, 1899-1902, served as a link with his country's history, while his grandmother taught him to view reality through the lens of magic and superstition. García Márquez obeyed his father's wishes by studying law at the National University of Colombia, but his true passion was always writing. In 1950, he abandoned his legal studies and began working as a journalist. His journalism complemented his literary career, brought him into contact with other writers and journalists, such as the members of the Barranquilla group, so called because they met in the Colombian city of the same name, and led him to take an extended trip to Paris, where he met writers including Mario Vargas Llosa, Peruvian writer and Nobel Prize winner, born in 1936, and Julio Cortázar, Argentinian writer, 1914-1984. Vargas Llosa and Cortázar were key members of the Latin American boom, a literary movement which emerged in the 1960s and introduced the world to the work of some of the continent's most outstanding writers. García Márquez's best-known novel, 100 Years of Solitude, was published in 1967, sold 8,000 copies in a single week and catapulted him to worldwide fame. In 1982, he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature for a literary career that spanned almost 50 years, from the novella Leaf Storm in 1955 to his final work, Memories of My Melancholy Horse, in 2004. An extended period of declining health began in 1999, when he was diagnosed with lymphatic cancer. He died on April 17, 2014, in Mexico City. The work. As its title suggests, the ending of the novella Chronicle of a Death Foretold is revealed on its first page. The reader immediately finds out that the main character, Santiago Nassar, will be killed by Pablo and Pedro Vicario in an attempt to defend the honor of their sister Angela, who married the mysterious Bayardo San Roman, a new arrival in town, the day before, but does not love him. However, on their wedding night, Bayardo learned that Angela was not a virgin and sent her home, where she gave in to pressure from her mother and admitted that she lost her virginity to Santiago Nassar. Her brothers Pablo and Pedro then feel obligated to defend the family's honor and decide to kill Santiago. Virtually all the town's inhabitants know that the two brothers are looking for Santiago in order to kill him, but everyone has their reasons for not warning him, and after a series of coincidences, he is stabbed to death in front of his house. Years later, the narrator investigates the events of that fateful day in an attempt to uncover exactly how the tragedy came about. Summary. The first-person narrator of Chronicle of a Death Foretold is a friend of Santiago Nassar who has taken it upon himself to put the pieces of his story together. Years after his friend's murder, he decides to return to the town to investigate what happened by speaking to witnesses, reading reports, letters, and accounts, and reconstructing the events of that tragic day in February. The novella consists of a number of interrelated strands, the events of the day of the murder, the judge's report with witness statements given a few days after the murder, the narrator's interviews with witnesses and participants over 20 years later, and the chronicle he writes. It is a polyphonic text, with multiple voices and perspectives which often contradict one another, as the narrator tries to gather the information he needs to reconstruct the events of the day of the murder. The night before the murder. Santiago Nassar is 21 years old and lives in an unnamed town on the Colombian coast. He runs his family ranch and, like most men his age, spends his free time going out with his friends, drinking heavily, going to parties, meeting women, and, occasionally, visiting prostitutes. He is engaged to his long-term girlfriend Flora Miguel, but has long been in love with another woman. The night before he was murdered, he stayed out partying until 4 a.m. with his friends, the narrator and Cristo Bedoya. They were at Angela Vicario and Bayardo San Roman's wedding, an enormous celebration that everyone in the town was invited to. The couple's courtship was brief and they were only engaged for 4 months, as Bayardo wanted to get married quickly. The narrator says that Bayardo believed that money can buy happiness, which was why he threw a huge party to celebrate his wedding. He enjoys talking about money, and is pleased when Santiago and his friends spend the evening speculating about how much the wedding could have cost. Santiago gets up at 5:30 the following morning, tired and hungover, and goes to the port like everyone else in town to see the bishop, who is rumored to be planning to disembark from his official boat to greet the faithful and bless the sick. He has no idea that he has less than 2 hours to live. He dresses more elegantly than he normally would for a day at the ranch, drinks a cup of strong coffee, and, unusually for him, leaves through the front door. Outside his house, he meets Cristo Bodea and talks to him about the events of the night before and the cost of the wedding. Margot, the narrator's sister, invites him to have breakfast with them afterwards. Many of the town's inhabitants know that the Vicario brothers are looking for him to kill him, but they say nothing when they see him chatting with his friends and acquaintances with his usual calm, cheerful demeanor outside his house because they assume that somebody else has already warned him. Meanwhile, as usual, the bishop greets and blesses the faithful from his boat, which does not even stop moving. The day of the murder. During the wedding celebrations, the newlyweds retire to the magnificent old mansion that Bayardo bought from the widower Chios. It is the most beautiful and best situated house in the town. However, at 3 a.m. Bayardo smuggles Angela back to her family's house, claiming that the marriage must be annulled because she is not a virgin. When her mother hears this, she flies into a rage and beats Angela, before telling her two brothers, Pedro and Pablo, what has happened. They now feel that it is up to them to restore the family's honor by killing Santiago Nassar. As the brothers look for weapons to kill Santiago, they tell many onlookers about their plans before sitting in wait in a shop near his house. They are in for a long wait, as Santiago only appears a few hours later on his way back from seeing the bishop. The brothers stab him to death in front of his house, making no attempt to conceal their actions from the town's other inhabitants. They are then arrested and questioned, while the rest of the Vicario family decides to flee to another town. 27 years later. The reader learns about Santiago's murder 27 years after it took place, when the narrator decides to return to the town to investigate and interview witnesses, in order to reconstruct the events of that day. He speaks to his own mother, Santiago's mother, the people who saw Santiago walking with Cristo Bedoya, the family's housekeeper and her daughter, and Angela Vicario, who fled the town after the murder and has still not returned. This explains why the story is described as of Chronicle. The narrator takes a journalistic approach, interviewing everyone who knows.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.